In this lesson, we are going to discuss the second use of a potentiometer. We have a potentiometer which is having a cell of EMF E, internal resistance small r, and this is connected to a potentiometer wire. Now, here is another circuit which is having, say, two resistances R1 and R2 connected to a cell of EMF E1 and internal resistance small R1, and some current is going here. First, we want to find the current. We know R1, we want to find the current in this circuit exactly. A potentiometer will give us the exact value of current. So we connect the plus of this to the plus of that, so this is connected. And here we connect a galvanometer and we find the balance point. At the balance point, current to the galvanometer is zero. So current is circulating in the bottom circuit independent of the current in the top circuit. So some current is flowing through the potentiometer, that is constant, and here also some steady current is flowing. And you want to find this current, let's call that I1. So we want to find out I1. Now, this length we can measure. This is the balance length. And the potential drop across that length will be given by Z into L1, because Z is the potential drop per unit length across the potentiometer wire, that we call it potential gradient. And if we go from here to here and here back here and travel this loop and apply KVL, so now we are applying KVL to loop ADEFA. First, there's a potential drop from here to here, that is given by minus V AD. Then we are going this way. Here the current is going this way. This is plus, this is minus. So we are going up in potential. So plus I1 R1. This, we are coming back to the original point, so it will be zero. Therefore, VAD, which is Z into L1, this is nothing but VAD, is equal to I1 R1. So I1 R1 will be equal to Z into L1. And therefore I1 is Z L1 by R1. So this way we can get the exact value of current, because this current is now not getting disturbed by this equipment. If we connect an ammeter, the circuit gets disturbed because ammeter has got some resistance, even though that resistance is small, but some resistance is there, it disturbs the circuit. This potentiometer at the balance point is not taking any current from this circuit. So this current is measured accurately, and this current will be equal to Z into L1 by R1. If we know R1, we can find I1. And once we know I1, and if we don't know R2, we can connect this R2 to this circuit in a similar manner as you've connected R1 here, and then we can find R2. So by using this setup, we can find current if resistance is known, and we can find resistance if current is known.